I hope you are doing well along with your loved ones. The last 1.5 years has been very, very critical for us. There's been so much of grief around us. You know, people have lost their jobs, people have lost their loved ones. So I thought this was a time when we needed to empower counselors to be able to reach out to people who are going through grief. So I have come out with a very short-term course. It's called Certificate in Grief Counseling. So I'll just give you a brief idea about what this course is all about, and then you can decide whether you want to come for this course, right? So the course details are, this course is going to be for 8 weeks. It's going to last for 8 weeks, and there's going to be one class per week. So which essentially means that you're going to be attending 8 sessions in the whole course, right? You've attended all the 8 sessions, you complete the course, and each session is going to be for 2.5 hours, right? So essentially you're going to spend 2.5 hours per week for 8 weeks to complete this course. There are going to be 2 batches in this course. There's going to be a weekday batch. It's going to be on Wednesdays from 10:30 to 1 o'clock in the afternoon, right? And for those who cannot come on the weekdays, who are busy otherwise, they can come for the weekend batches, which is going to be on Sundays. And the Sunday timing is from 11 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Sundays, I have kept it a little half an hour delayed, you know, compared to the weekdays, because I understand that people are more relaxed on Sundays. So they can come half an hour later at 11 o'clock, right? And the course duration is, the weekday batch, it's going to start from 10th of November. That's going to be the second Wednesday of November. It's going to end on the last Wednesday of December. That's on the 29th December. And the weekend batch is going to start 3 days earlier. It's going to start on 7th of November after the Diwali festival is over. And it's going to end on 26th December, which is the last Sunday of December. So both the courses are going to last for 8 weeks. And there's going to be an admission criteria in this course. This course is not going to cover the basics of counseling. So that's why I need that the people who enroll for this course should have at least the basic understanding of counseling. So they should be qualified with a degree, diploma, certificate in mental health, you know, either counseling, psychology or social work, whatever area they have done in mental health. They should have some qualification so that they know how to interact with people and how to counsel people, right? Alternatively, if you are not qualified, at least you should be experienced as a volunteer. Now, there are many people who are not qualified in the mental health field, but there are a lot of experience. You know, they have come as volunteers, as counselors in hospitals, in different places. So they can also join this course if they have already done a lot of counseling in their life. Some of the topics that are going to be covered in this course, grief is a very exhaustive subject. So I have tried to bring in a lot of depth to this course. So some of the topics that are going to be covered is, of course, a deeper understanding of grief. What exactly happens to a person when they're going through a grief? And what are the different emotions that come in when they go through a bereavement? While sadness is not the only emotion that a person goes through, it's important to understand all the other emotions that they go through when they have a bereavement. And that's going to be a deeper understanding of grief. Of course, there's going to be an assessment of grief. You know, you need to assess a person, you know, what is the kind of help that they need. So there's going to be an how to do an assessment for grief on different parameters, like physical parameter, spiritual parameter, or psychological parameters. You know, how do you help? How do you make an assessment for them? And there's going to be counseling for grief. You know, grief counseling essentially is 2 parts. You know, you counsel for grief, and then you counsel for rebuilding. Counseling for grief is counseling for the loss that they have suffered. That's the past part of it. And counseling for rebuilding is for the future part of it. How do you help them to rebuild their lives? So that's going to be another topic. And apart from this core area of counseling for grief, there are some special areas in grief counseling, and one of them is ambiguous grief. You know, ambiguous grief results from ambiguous loss, when you're not certain that you have lost something. As an example, suppose somebody is missing from home, right? Somebody has gone away from home and we don't know where they have gone. So that's a loss, but it's not a permanent loss, or we don't know if it's a permanent loss. That's called an ambiguous grief. And how do you deal with that? For another example of ambiguous grief that I can give is that we lose somebody to mental illness. You know, like somebody is gone through mental illness where they're no longer the same kind of a person that they were. Right? That's also ambiguous grief. Or somebody, we have lost them to addiction. Right? A family member, we have lost them to addiction. They're physically present, but psychologically they're no longer the same person. That's called ambiguous grief. So we're going to take a look at that. Then we're going to take a look at grief and children. You know, how children process grief. So that's going to be an interesting and important session, you know, because children process grief very differently from adults do, and different ages of children process it very differently. So how do you understand that and how do you counsel children who have gone through bereavement. There's going to be another topic on anticipated grief. Anticipated grief comes from a person suffering from terminal illness, right? They have their own grief, plus the family members of such person also go through what's called as anticipated grief. So how do you handle that part of it? And then disenfranchised grief is another topic in grief counseling. Disenfranchised grief comes from a kind of a grief that's not accepted by society or that can't be expressed openly. Like, you know, you lose a pet, people don't really empathize with you when you do that much. There's been an abortion. Those are all disenfranchised grief. People will feel like, you know, why is somebody grieving for a relationship that did not exist? But this grief is real. So that's a disenfranchised grief that's going to be looked at. I'll be the principal faculty in this course. I'll be taking the majority of the sessions, but I'm bringing in a host of guest faculty lectures for you. For example, Aarti Rajaratnam, who has worked extensively with children in disaster management areas where there has been natural disasters. Ishwar Sundaresan is another very well-known counselor who has done extensive work in counseling field. Ashwini is a very well-known faculty as an academic. She has worked in many institutions. She has got her own foundation, Mukta Foundation, which looks at children's rehabilitation. So these are some of the guest faculties who will be taking a session on different aspects of grief. And you have to register before 30th October, that's the last date, because the course is going to begin in the first week of November. And you can contact two people here. One is Sadhika Patel, 9886044221, or alternatively Sujata Jairam is also available for giving you the details about this course. She can be contacted on 99 followed by 40s and 2509. Right? I really hope to see you in this course. Thank you for your time.